Hi, Alusain here. In the last lesson on demand and supply, we looked at the theory of demand and supply, the laws of demand and supply. We looked at the behavior of consumers, individuals, and suppliers, businesses, producers, okay, and how together their behavior determine the equilibrium price and quantity in a market economy, okay? Then we also looked at the idea of a market. We finally ended up by talking about the idea of producer and consumer surplus as a measure of welfare, where we gave the example of, say, you come to the market to buy an orange, you were willing and able, which is demand, effective demand, to pay 70 leones, but actually your metric price was 65 leones. So you went home extremely happy that you had a good deal. While the seller also came, she was willing and able. She was willing to sell the oranges for 60 leones, but actually you paid 65 leones. She also went home extremely happy that you've paid really well. Okay, but often businesses and government have to make very important decisions. Okay, actually moving on from this topic, we shall talk about government intervention. Price controls, we'll look at subsidies and indirect taxation, okay? But it's important that we talk about this because you'll just see how important this topic really is, okay? Often, firms have to decide to predict what would happen to their revenues if prices change. They'll have to think about comparing quantities and price changes, and also to see, is it possible for me to charge a higher price in this market, say maybe in Sierra Leone? Is it possible for me to charge a higher price, say maybe in America, for my product and things like that? And also, it's really, really important for the next lesson, they also have to ask if the government suddenly brings a tax on the product I'm selling, will I be able to pass on the burden of this tax to the consumer, the people buying my product, or not? And for the side of the government, of course, they often have to tax demerit goods, okay? So goods like alcoholic beverages, cigarettes, certain drugs that are harmful or considered demoralizing in a society like Tramadol, as we had in Sierra Leone here. So governments have to see, if I tax this good, what the idea of elasticity comes really important, whereas this burden of this tax, is it going directly to consumers or is it going to the sellers? Okay, so government has to think about these important topics, and also what will happen if a currency is devalued in a fixed exchange rate system. Of course, exchange rate systems are not something we talk about here. Look at them in macroeconomics. Okay, so but this is very, very important. So that's the idea for elasticity of demand. Businesses and government also have to think about what happens to demand when incomes change. Okay, this helps businesses to know, shall we invest in this new product or not, looking at the income elasticity of demand. And for government, of course, they will have to forecast to see what will happen to different sectors in our economy, right? So as incomes increase, see, when we had the boom in Sierra Leone, our economy was really, really growing really fast. Governments have to be thinking carefully what sectors will be affected by this growth, the changes in income, okay? That's very important. And also we have to often think about what happens to the price of a good when the quantity demanded of a good, when the price of other goods, other related goods are changing, okay? What happens to the sales, to the quantity demanded of sweetie Maggi if Dolly prices are rising? What happens to the quantity demanded of ice fish if smoked fish becomes expensive? All those questions are very important. Or whether it's a compliment, considering coffee and sugar, or the example I gave earlier about boots and socks, they are consumed together, or maybe they are just unrelated. All these concepts are very important. And finally, on the idea of elasticity, price elasticity of supply, we look at to what extent a change in demand is going to affect the price or the quantity, or both the price and quantity of the good in the market. Okay, so clearly we see that this concept is very important. But what is elasticity in the first place? Well, elasticity is simply the responsiveness. In general, it talks about responsiveness. Responsiveness of some economic variable to changes in another variable. Okay, so in the case of, for example, the elasticity of demand, we look at price elasticity of demand. To what extent, how responsive is the quantity demanded of a product given a change in the price of that good? Okay, we look at it in the area of income also. To what extent does the quantity of a good demanded change with response to changes in the incomes of consumers? And in the case of cross price elasticity, what happens to the quantity demanded of a good considering changes in the prices of other related goods? Okay, so elasticity talks mainly about responsiveness, right? So the idea, you can imagine the idea of those catapults we use, the elastic bands. Okay, some with little force they expand a lot. For some, you have to go really hard before they expand a little bit. Okay, so you can think about it in these terms. Also, I drew here, you can see the idea of wind and wind in a storm and how much different plants bend. Okay, for some plants, the same force of wind that blows, some bend really low. For some, it's really hard for them. They do not respond as much. Okay, it takes a lot more wind for them to bend. Right? They are not as responsive as this one. Right? So just to give you an example. So what we'll first look at the idea of elasticity of demand, and then we'll look at elasticity of supply, price elasticity, because this one, our most important focus is on price elasticity. Right? First, we look at price elasticity of demand. When we talk about elasticity of demand in general, we are referring to the price of the good, the own price. Okay, so what happens? The percentage change in the quantity demanded of a good, given the percentage change in the price of that good. Okay, so the own price, the price of that good itself. Okay, so the key idea here we have to note is that price elasticity of demand is negative. Okay, although often when we talk about it, we ignore the negative sign, but price elasticity of demand is negative simply because price and quantity demanded, as we talked about in the law of demand, they move in opposite directions. Okay, if price goes down, that becomes negative, right? Quantity demanded goes up. So it will always be negative. It will always be negative because, say for example, price was 5 yens. It goes, okay, yes, if price goes up to now say 6 yens, what happens to quantity demanded? Let us just assume we are quantity demanded. According to the law of demand, when price goes up, quantity goes down. So if quantity was 10 units, now it has to go down to 9 units. Okay, so now 5 minus 6, this gives us a negative number. Minus 1 divided by 10 minus 9 is 1. So minus 1 divided by 1 is minus. So let us consider this in the opposite way. Say now supply was, sorry, yes, price was 5 yens, and now it goes down to 4 yens. Okay? This is the same, it will still be a negative number because now if demand was 10 units, 10 oranges, because of the lower price, now quantity demanded is going to rise according to the law of demand. So say now it is 12 oranges. So this will be equal to 5 minus 4, which is 1, divided by 10 minus 12, which is minus 2. We are just assuming here, okay? Minus 2. So this is, if there is nothing in front of a number, we assume it is positive. So plus divided by minus is minus, okay? So this is minus half. So this is still negative, So whether the price rises or the price goes down, price elasticity of demand is always negative, right? But when we talk about it, when we talk about, often when it is discussed, this negative sign is often ignored. But if you are doing calculations, do not forget to put the negative sign in the calculation, okay? Now, so yes, we are talking. So not price elasticity of demand is negative, okay? Although we normally ignore this. For example, imagine if the price of barbing goes up, the barbing shop suddenly it becomes more expensive, you expect people to shave their hairs less, okay? Or if suddenly top up becomes more expensive, people buy less top up, okay? Good. So this idea, we are going to look at elasticity of demand along a particular demand curve. Right? What happens is that price elasticity of demand varies along a demand curve. Okay? Price elasticity of demand varies along a demand curve. But maybe before we even do that, let us look at an example of a demand function, and we see the effect of a change in price, how that affects quantity demanded. Right? So let us imagine a demand function represented by, say quantity demanded is equal to, say, 25 minus 3p. Okay? This function can be determined in many ways. Maybe through previous sales that I made sure I noted in a particular book, I have suspected that the quantity demanded of my oranges behave this way. Okay, the quantity demanded is always 25 minus 3 times the price. This is how it behaves. For other demand functions, say maybe the woman selling cookery, it might be different. Okay, maybe it's 35 plates minus 2 times this. Right? So it's different for different goods, or even if it's the same product for different, maybe different sellers, it's different considering the different environment we sell. So we say we have an example of the demand function like this. And then the price, we are given, if the price is 5 millions, we expect the quantity, the units of oranges sold to be, if price equal to 5 millions, quantity, then this implies that the quantity demanded should be equal to 25 minus 3 times P, which is the price. Okay, P here is 5. Forgive my writing, please. So we say quantity is equal to 25 minus 3 times 5 is 15. 25 minus 15 is what? 10 units. So we expect 10 units of oranges to be sold when the price is 5 millions. Right? So let us say this is our initial price. This is how I used to sell my oranges. And then suddenly I decide to increase the, okay, say lower the price of my oranges. Right? If I lower the price of my oranges, say to 4.6 millions, okay? Let me use a different color. I say 4.6 million. If price becomes suddenly 4.6 million, this implies that quantity demanded now becomes, the quantity changes to 25. This is the behavior I expect. 25 minus 3 times the price, which is now 4.6. So this is going to be equal to 3 times 4.6, let me this is easy, 3 times 4.6, 13.8, right? So this becomes 25 minus 13.8, yes. 25 minus 13.8 gives me 11.2. 11.2. What we see here, when we lowered the price, quantity demanded rose to 11.2 units. before I sold, let us assume it's possible for you to sell in fractional amounts. Okay, you can cut an orange into different parts. So when we sold at 5 lions, quantity demanded was 10 units, 10 oranges. Now when we reduced the price to 4.6 lions, that is a 0.4 lions decrease, the quantity rose to 11.2 units. So there is a change in the quantity demanded. Okay, so this change is now the new quantity. So the change in quantity demanded is equal to the change in the new quantity, which is 11.2 minus the old quantity, which is 11, which is 10. Okay, so we can, of course, that is equal to 1.2. All right, now this is the change in the quantity demanded. But when we talk about the price elasticity of demand, we are talking about absolute changes. Okay, we are looking at the proportional change. Okay, that is why we change it to a percentage. Right, so now if we want to find the percentage change in quantity demanded divided by the percentage change in price, we will say price elasticity of demand is often represented by this symbol. So we say this here, assume we are moving from this end coming down here, elasticity is equal to the percentage change in quantity demanded. Now we know the change in quantity demanded is 1.2, okay, because we found the earlier quantity and then the new quantity when we change the price. So this is equal to 1.2 divided by the original quantity demanded, which is 10, okay, which is 10 times 100, because this is a percentage. Okay, so we divide this by the change in the price. Now the original price was 5 lions, was 5 lions, 5 lions minus 5 lions, and now the new price is, okay, let us do it out here. We have now the new price is 4.6 lions minus the original, which was 5 lions. Okay, so this gives us what? Minus 0.4 lions. This is the change. Remember, the change is negative because the price fell. Okay, the price fell down. Now the new one, just the same we did with the quantity here, the new quantity is 11.2 minus the old quantity, which is 10. The same we do here, the new price is 4.6 minus the old price, which is 5. Because it fell, we see directly that the answer is minus. Right? So this is going to be minus 0.4. So the change divided by the original price, which is 5 lions, times 100. Okay? So now we can just say 1.2. Of course, here we know 0 can cancel 0. So this is just 1.2 times 10, which is 12 basically. 12 divided by, we say, okay, let's say 5 into itself, 1 into 100, into, okay, let's say 5 into itself, 1 into 10, 2 times, and then there is 0, so we just add this 0, okay, so it is 20, so minus, so 0.4, so this here, so we have minus 0.4 times 20, so 0.4 times 20 gives us 8, so minus 8, right? Minus 0.4 times 20 is 8. Now what we do here, simply, we know, so let's say 4, for example, 4 comes into 8 2 times, 4 comes into 12 3 times, so therefore this becomes 3 over minus 2. But we know this is, if there is nothing in front of the 3, it is plus, plus divided by minus is minus, so we have minus 3 over 2. So this is our elasticity of price elasticity of demand. Okay, 3 over 2. This is the same as 1.5, because 3 divided by 2 is 1.5. Okay, so this is the same as minus 1.5. So this is how you calculate the price elasticity of demand. Remember, it is measuring the absolute change in the quantity demanded resulting from the change in the price. This is why we use the percentage, okay, to make it absolute. So we know now that this is a ratio, remember. So anytime if we change, so quantity demanded changes 3 units. Whenever we change price, 2 units. So this is a ratio, don't forget, okay? So we see it is negative here, it is negative. Price elasticity of demand is negative here, okay? This concept is very important when we talk about, when we look at this graph here, okay? Along a demand curve, price elasticity of demand changes, okay, from infinity to zero, okay? We will ignore this negative sign as I told you earlier, okay, but it is always negative, don't forget. Price elasticity of demand is always negative because price and quantity demanded always move in opposite directions. When one goes up, the one goes down. When one goes down, the one goes up. So there will always be a negative sign, okay? So now, let us then talk about the idea of elastic demand, elastic demand and inelastic demand. Okay, when the change in price results in a greater change in the quantity demanded, we say that the demand for the product, the price elasticity of demand for that product is elastic. Okay, often this is when it is greater than, when it is more negative than one. This is when it is more negative than one. So you see that there is a range of elasticity we have. While published, you can always rewind the video, okay? There is a range. We have, say we have one here. Remember this is negative, but we ignore it. We have zero. And then this tends to infinity. Infinity is represented by this, and it just means it's continuous, okay? It's a very large number, right? So now, here at this range between, when it is greater than one, demand is considered to be elastic, okay? When it is between one and zero, it is considered to be inelastic. We say it is inelastic when a change in price results in a less than proportionate change in the quantity demanded. Okay, so now but when it is exactly equal to one, we say it is unit elastic. When it is unit elastic, the percentage change in the price is equal to the percentage change in the quantity demanded. Okay. So it is equal, the proportion is equal, not in this case where we had 3 to 2. In this case, it is 1 is to 1. So that's why we have the elasticity here is supposed to be 1. Okay, not forgetting that before we ignore the negative sign, because price elasticity of demand is always negative. Now, so consider this, okay? So elasticity varies along a demand curve, right? So we see here at higher prices along the demand curve, at higher prices we see that demand is more elastic. So demand, the quantity demanded of a good responds more to changes in price, okay? So often this is why it's all, we talk about the idea of the relationship between price elasticity of demand and the revenues of a firm, okay? I told you it's really important that businesses know what will happen to their revenues when prices change, okay? Often, it is the case that at higher prices, at this range between 1 and infinity, when the elasticity is between 1 and infinity, often the quantity demanded of a product responds more to changes in the price. So at these ranges, often when a firm reduces the price, it often experiences improvements in revenue. Okay, when you lower the price at this range around here, where elasticity of demand is between, remember this is what I took here, okay? When the elasticity of demand is between 1 and infinity. Remember, this is supposed to be my negative 1 to negative infinity, but we ignore the negative sign, okay? So when elasticity is between, is greater than 1, but tends to infinity, we say, at those ranges, when a firm reduces the price, it tends to experience an increase in revenues, okay? These diagrams I brought here, this represents the total revenue curve. The idea is that the revenues of a firm will rise. They rise, they are positive. They are positive when the range, when we are in the elastic range of the demand curve. Okay? If we are in this range, revenues are positive. So if we lower the price in this range, we are going to experience higher revenues. So it is good for firms to know where they are along their demand curve. Okay, but below unit elasticity, here at unit elastic, I told you earlier, the percentage change in price is just equal to the percentage change in the quantity that is demanded. It is equal. Okay, that is why elasticity is equal to 1 to 1 changes. Okay, so once we pass this range and we come down, if the firm, now we are at the inelastic range. Here, the quantity demanded of a good responds less to changes in the price. Okay, so at this range here, if we continue to lower the price, we are actually going to have lower revenues. Okay, remember, revenue is what a firm or a business gets from selling. Whenever you sell a plate of rice, the money you get is the revenue from the sale. Okay, so there is a particular point. Below that point, if you lower the price now, well, you will not improve your revenue. Okay, revenues are very, very important for businesses because their goal is to increase their profits. Profits are the key, as we talked about earlier in the theory of supply. Okay, profit making is the goal of firms and businesses, right? So price elasticity of demand is closely related to the idea of the revenues of a firm, the revenues of a firm, okay? Now, we have different types, we'll say, of constant price elasticities of demand. Of course, here we have unit elasticity of demand, of course, is constant. Okay, we also have perfectly inelastic price elasticity of demand. For perfectly inelastic price elasticity of demand, we see that the demand curve is vertical, that is standing straight like this. Okay, here changes in price do not affect the quantity demanded of a good. It does not move. Even if you change the price from this price to this price, we are still, customers are still willing and able to buy only this amount. So changing the price does not affect the quantity that people are willing to buy. This often has to do with things that addictive drugs. If someone is addicted to a particular drug, to a cigarette, even if you raise the price a little bit, it will not affect the amount of cigarettes they buy, okay? Because they are addicted to these goods. Of course, alcohol and things like that. This is also important when you think about drugs, certain types of drugs, like life-saving drugs. If someone is having, say, sickle cell, right? They have to go and buy a particular medicine, say maybe insulin for people who are having diabetes. The price, uh, the, their the elasticity of demand for such drugs will basically be zero.